Guys, Ted All Sports Center to be going over a recap and reaction on Michigan and Wisconsin. This game really was a big surprise to me. And I thought Wisconsin was going to win. I'll go over that in a couple minutes. But man, this was a surprise at how much Wisconsin dominated this game. Of course, previously to this game, though, Wisconsin did end up beating their opponents, or they actually shut out both of their opponents. One of them was South Florida. I mean, man, Wisconsin looks really good right now, and I think going into the rest of the season, this is going to be a team that you need to watch out for, especially in the Big Ten West. Previous to the season starting, I mean, there was a lot of talk about Nebraska and stuff. I think that's kind of what fueled Wisconsin there. They're making a statement right now for sure. They won this game 35-14 over Michigan, and Wisconsin came out swinging in this game. They had a good touchdown to start off the game, but then they got another score towards the end of the first quarter, and then they ended up going into the half like 28-0 or something like that. It was crazy how much Wisconsin was dominating this game. Michigan just looked straight up unprepared. They were leaving major gaps. Like, I was watching a few highlights of this game earlier, and man, they were just leaving open so many spots that this should be covered. Michigan's defense was absolutely being shredded by Jonathan Taylor. Jonathan Taylor dominated this game. He had over 200 yards rushing in this game, and he's really what Wisconsin needed to win. And of course, Wisconsin's always been really, really good with the rushing core. I mean, you can kind of go back to like, who else do they have? They had Melvin Gordon, Monte Ball, and so all of those players, I mean, leading up to Jonathan Taylor, they've all been very, very good. Wisconsin's always very good with the rushing core. But Shea Patterson had an absolutely terrible day. He had terrible stats. I think at one point, they benched him and they put in another quarterback. I think his name is Dylan McCaffrey. And I mean, he did okay. He ended up getting injured, which would knock him out of the rest of the game. But yeah, Wisconsin's defense continues to be a strong side for them. And I think, honestly, Wisconsin isn't usually as known for defense. They're more known for offense. But man, this defense looks strong this season. And that's going to be a dangerous point for a lot of people. You better have a good offense if you're going to play Wisconsin, it seems like, right now. Here's your stat comparison, though, for this game. Lots of interesting things here. I mean, you got Shea Patterson, 14 for 32. That is straight up embarrassing. That is below 50%. And he had 219 yards, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception. Dylan McCaffrey actually was he's a quarterback, but he was their leading rusher today with 21 yards. Michigan did not use any rusher, or they did not use any running backs today. I mean, I think their best running back had 17 yards. Dylan McCaffrey beat that by 4. Man, that's just absurd. I mean, you need to have a running core if you're going to be able to compete with teams like Wisconsin, it seems like, right now. Nico Collins, that wide receiver, he was second in yards rise, but he was number one in receptions. So he had 3 receptions, 66 yards. They split up a lot of the yards between many receivers here today. Tariq Black, he had 3 receptions for 57 yards. Ronnie Bell, 2 receptions, 81 yards, so he led in yardage. But none of those guys had touchdowns. There were a couple other wide receivers that got the touchdowns. One of them was Peoples Jones. Then looking at the Wisconsin side, of course, Jack Cohn, he had more of a quiet day because Jonathan Taylor was just putting up a storm, but he was 13 for 16, 128 yards, 2 touchdowns, and no interceptions. Once again, Jonathan Taylor, 23 attempts and for 203 yards and 2 touchdowns. Frederick Shaw, 3 attempts for 53 yards. He's another running back. He was a running back too today. So really on the run, they put up 256 yards, and that's not even that was just between those two running backs. They had more rushers going at it. But wide receiver wise, Garrett Groshek, sorry if I'm pronouncing any of these guys wrong. 2 receptions, 38 yards. Jake Ferguson, tight end, 3 receptions for 28 yards. So overall, yeah, really good offensively day for Wisconsin. It was more of a slow second half, but really, I think they were doing okay otherwise. I mean, their defense was really holding it up. But here's my prediction for the preview that I released earlier this week. You can go back and watch that if you'd like to, and just kind of reflect on that, I guess. But yeah, at halftime, I said 21-10 Wisconsin. Ended up being 20-0, and then in the final, I said Wisconsin was going to win it by 11. And they ended up winning it by much, much more. I thought it'd be more of a closer game. I thought that Michigan would stick with it for the majority of the time, but that is certainly not the case. Wisconsin, though, would win it 42-31. Once again, your final score was 35-14. Here's up next for both of these teams. Michigan hosts Rutgers next week. They are 1-2 right now. Rutgers is looking pretty terrible, so Michigan should be able to bounce back with the win there. And same for Wisconsin, it seems like, as Northwestern lost today to Michigan State. They lost earlier. They were at that one noon game. Now Northwestern is 1-2 as well. Northwestern's really off to a slow start. And, I mean, they lost a ton of talent after last year. And so that's kind of that's a good reason why they're kind of in the position that they are. But, yeah, should get a win there for both of these teams next week. So, thank you guys all for watching. Stay tuned for more from All Sports Central. We'll be going over a couple more recaps, I think, this week. We'll probably do Georgia, Notre Dame, and possibly Auburn and Texas A&M, except Auburn's kind of beating them up right now. And so we'll see what happens there. But, yeah, thank you guys all for watching once again. Subscribe for more if you'd like to, and I'll see you all later.